Our next finalist, Cropin, provides farmers with farm management tools, software and mobile apps that enables them to do connected and data-driven farming. In short, making every farm and farmer traceable. Please put your hands together for Krishna Kumar from Cropin. All right, your slide is up. Your time starts now.
Hi, this is Krishna, and I founded Cropin Technology. We are an agtech startup, and we basically work in the agriculture ecosystem, working closely with the government, NGOs, corporates, input companies, fertilizer companies, or banks or insurance companies. Why we started this? I was working at a GE, and our job was to make every factory profitable, and we believe that every plot is a factory. How can we optimize it? That was an idea. And that triggered because it was more of an EQ question than an IQ question. We didn't came here to make money, we came here to solve a large problem. The farmers were doing suicide, the yields are low, and so many other challenges, like, you know, we recently heard that the tomatoes are thrown in the road, or, you know, farmers in the market, they are distributed free because they are not getting the right realization. And we thought, how can we solve all these challenges? And the only thing, if we can bring all these stakeholders together on a platform to interact and solve this problem together. So that was an idea. We came up with the cloud and mobile-based technology to engage all these ecosystem players together. So we build a solution which works for everybody, for the farmer, for the contract farming companies, for the NGOs, for the governments, and whoever is trying to work closely with the farmer. Our idea was to deliver per acre value. When we say per acre value, value for the whole ecosystem. And our data-driven approach combined with data science, satellite, and weather, which is a key to our solutioning. So we got portfolio of products. One is a smart farm, which is more towards the farming from planning till harvesting, where whoever is working closely with the farmer, it could be McCain, ITC, or Big Basket, or a government or NGO can work closely, provide a better package of practices or real-time advisory to the farmer. Return, they get a better quality output from their farms, which they can use it for processing or whatever way they want to, whether they want to export or consume it internally. And then there is a Ember Warehouse solution, which is targeted towards post-harvesting. So imagine if there is a packet of grapes which is sold in UK, somebody scans that 500 gram of grape, it will tell you where it is coming from, what is the origin of it. This is live right now, so one of the largest exporters of the grapes from India is using this solution. In Kharghar, you can walk into the store, buy a half kg palak, scan that palak, it will tell you which farm it is coming from when it was harvested. So that's the solution, is an add-on on the smart farm solution. These are some of the customers like McCain, Louis Riffers, Philip Morris, or Big Basket, Shadri Farm, or Atlantic Sun Farm in Portugal using this solution. Smart Sale is more towards fertilizer and pesticide company engaging the farmers to educate them better how to use the particular solution, provide advisory, and also run their promotions on that platform. Smart Risk is towards bank and insurance companies. So banks now working closely with the farmer to give them a loan. With Cropin solution, they are able to provide a better solution and engage the farmer better with them. We charge per acre $3 to $10. To the company, not to the farmer, and per user license $100 to $500. These are some of the customers we are working with. So Philip Morris, Louis Riffers, Marico, Lexus Cotton, Big Basket, all other names here. We are going global with these companies. IDS has signed up 6 million farmers with us across the globe. 5 lakh farmers, 1 million acre managed till date, 1.2 million interaction with the farmers, 50,000 issues solved at the farm in the real time. 3 lakh farm images has been captured in the system. We have grown 300% if you compare last year to this year. We have, our smart farm product is EBITDA positive. This is how we want to grow in a couple of years. So we had 8 countries, 15 Indian states, 100 plus companies, 70 plus crops, 1760 varieties. We want to add 25,000 farms, and also we are targeting to add 20 million farms on the platform in the next 5 years. And we want to enable data analytics and product services on our platform. This is a reach we have with the farmers across India and other parts of the countries. This is how a farmer decides over the, there is a plot and there is a farmer scorecard which is used by the different companies. And then we can monitor the farm with a satellite every 10 days. We break the plot into 10 by 10 meter and we can talk about exactly which part has a problem, and we also predict the yield. In Punjab, you point out the plot, we can tell you what could be the yield on that plot. That kind of machine learning, AI and data science we applied over a period of time. This is how we monitor the plot every 10 days, and it changes, and at the end you'll find the, you know, yield. And then we look at the larger area also. We predict the taluka or a district or a state. We did it for ICS Lombard this year for soybean.
All right, thank you, Krishna. Your time's up. Jury Thanks. Questions?
So this is pretty much on the solution side.
Can you talk a little bit about your, what's unique about the technology that allows you to do this? Just elaborate on that a little bit.
So if you look at, farming has never been digitized. So there's no data around. Whether you work, we go to PepsiCo, you go to government, nobody knows what is live happening right now in the farm. The unique capability of the CropIn is that we have been working with the live data for the last 5 years, and we have got 70 crops. Based on that, we build a lot of models. We know how exactly potato behaves in Patiala or in you know, some part of Punjab or in Gujarat. And those models like machine learning and the data science help us to, you know, build the crop signatures and predict in the real time what could be the yield on the plot.
Can you elaborate on that a little bit? So you've got these machine learning algorithms. So
right.
The idea is you've got, your input is satellite images, is that right?
Data from the ground.
So you're getting data from the ground on yield and things like that from individual farms?
So while we are working with these companies, we are getting all this data over a period of time. Then we combine the weather and satellite along with that. Then we get a chlorophyll index, we get leaf area index, we get NDVI values for those plot every 10 days for 5x5 meter pixels.
How do you get that? From the satellite?
Satellite companies, yeah. So we use German satellites like Sentinel-2, which is 10x10 meter resolution. So a plot is broken into 10x10 meter. And then we build those algorithms to predict those plots in that particular area. We just did a project on the soybean in Madhya Pradesh. We predict the yield a month before, where we were like plus minus 10% accurate when they came out the final yield.
But to make those predictions, yeah, you need a lot of historical data on what was the actual yield.
So that's the advantage of the CropIn, because since we are working for the last 5 years, we have got 70 crops data live in our system from over five years. So that is helping us to build those models around. Also, with the technology evolving, if you bring a plot today, 1 acre, I can look back at last 2 years. So imagine a plot I'm looking at from 2014, I can predict the behavior of that plot over a period of time. Even the farmer has come on my platform today. So that's also given me ability to add and recognize which plot, I mean, whether he did corn last year and what was the health of the corn and what could have been the yield. That's how the bank are utilizing the solutions.
So the data is coming initially from your clients. They're telling you this particular farm, here was the yield, here's what happened, and then you're using that to
That's one time, yeah. So once you build a potato model, it applied everywhere.
And what do they do with that? Is it to identify which farms are doing better and which ones need training? Or?
For forecasting, they are into processing, they are into export, they are into various, if you look at NGOs, they are into development, like if they have increased the yield for the farmer from last year to this year or not. So every participant have their own benchmark to use this solution. Loans companies are looking at whether I should do business with this farmer or not. No, none of the bank want to give a loan to a farmer. But with this solution, we can tell that this farmer has been doing well for the last 3 years, and you can really bank with him because his economic value of the plots has been really good. So NAFA, ICC Bank, and a lot of other companies were using this solution today.
So the same farm can be show up in multiple client data sets for you through a bank, through an NGO, and so on?
No, we don't share data across it, but the algorithm is ours. So if there is a potato farm somewhere else in the part of the country, we can apply that algorithm there also. But the algorithm is getting trained over all the client's data.
So your clients are essentially corporates who are
corporates, governments also we are working.
And yeah. Individual, and what would be the market in India? How many of the farmers are under contract with corporates today?
So close to 10 million farmers are there. In country we have got like 140 million farmers. So, I mean, one is the India is, when you talk about the chemical companies, seed companies, they are reaching out to every farmer because they are selling their pesticide fertilizers to every farmer, and they need a solution to reach out to them. So in a way, 140 million farmer is my ecosystem today. If I reach out to all these fertilizer, seed, chemical companies. So right now, like Aditya Birla Group, MCF, they all are using our solutions.
what do they, I mean, how do they use it, for what is the purpose?
Couple of reasons. They spend a lot of money on the marketing, and also they run an advisory program to tell the farmer how do you do better farming, how can you, if you have this problem, how can you use my product to solve those problems, and that is a real-time communication happening with the farmer. And so that's how they engage. So right now they have a people on the ground to do a demo, product demo, provide personal services to the farmer. Now they're using technology to reach out to those farmers.
On that question on market size, so right now you have 5 lakh farmers and you're at $1 million run rate, is that right? Okay, and total about 140 million farmers, so roughly 300 times what you have right now. So $300 million market size, is that?
I think this is a $500 million market size. We did this report with the PwC.
Okay, so roughly that range. Okay.
But that is in India, and that is evolving over a period of time, But we are in 8 countries, so we are getting much better traction outside country because, you know, a lot of people are ready to adopt this kind of solution. Like Mozambique, we are working with 100,000 growers one shot with Plexus Cotton, which is the largest cotton growers in that country.
It's still substantially the larger farmers.
No.
With the marginal farmer.
So we have got like 60% farmer who is less than 1 acre.
But they're all under contract to a cooperative. They're not.
So either they're working with the, like we are working with the Jivika project of the government for the Bihar and MP. They're like very small farmers, 0.2 acres, 0.5 acres. Cooperatives are also working with a mix of the farmers. Like baby corn is like 0.2 acres, 0.1 acres, kind of a farmers also using this product.
All right, thank you, Krishna.
Yeah, thank you.
Ladies and gentlemen, a huge round of applause for CropIn.